Hey, what's going on, guys? Today we're going to be talking about the Ring Doorbell 2. If this is something you are interested in buying, I will be putting links in the description below for you to pick this up on Amazon. So let's start with the basics. If you look, it has a 1080p video with two-way talk, motion detection, a lifetime purchase protection. And what that means is that if this gets stolen, Ring will replace it for free. That's pretty cool. Has a quick release battery, which only comes in the Video Doorbell 2 as of right now, and is Wi-Fi connected. Flip it over to the back. This does have night vision, connects to your existing chime, which is nice. So when you push it, it'll ring inside the house. So one cool thing about Ring and the doorbell is that it comes with a lot of different accessories. If you don't have good Wi-Fi signal to your door, you can get extenders for this. If for some reason that you can't connect this to your current chime that you have in the house, you can also buy a box that would plug in, and this thing would, through Wi-Fi, connect to that chime. So when you push the button on here, it's gonna ring to the chime in your house, or it can ring to multiple chimes in your house. You could put one upstairs or downstairs. They also have built-in Wi-Fi extenders to that. So if your signal isn't strong either, you can have a boosted signal too if you need to get to your doorbell. Also, if you want to stick it somewhere other than your front door and you want to put it out by, say, a front gate or somewhere else, or maybe a back gate, you can use the extenders for that. Another thing too, say if you're running it out somewhere that doesn't have power, is they also have solar accessories for this too. So either a small solar panel that you can run, or a little base plate that goes around it that can absorb solar power too, so you can keep this thing charged and not have to worry about pulling that battery out every time it dies. All right, let's take a look what's in the box. All right, so this is everything that we have in the box. If we take a look, here is the camera right here with a silver faceplate. Inside is where the battery goes. We have got the battery right here with the quick release. Here is a plate. If you got the old camera, you can use this to connect the new camera to it. We've got the other cover here. Got the orange USB charger to plug into the battery, get that charged up. We've got the two angle plates. This is the one for side to side. This one here is for up and down. Got a bag of screws and anchors. And then in the toolbox, well, let's look what's in the toolbox. All right, in the toolbox, we have got the screwdriver, got a Torx on one side, Phillips head on the other side here, another bag of screws and anchors, and in the bag here, we've got a Mason drill bit, we've got some extender wires with nuts, also have a level here, and then inside of this bag here, we have a diode if you have a digital chime in the house. Let's go through the setup of what you need to do. First things first, you are gonna need to charge the battery. So pull that out. So you're gonna plug one side into a USB and then the other side is gonna go into the battery. Now this battery takes a long time to charge. I think mine was going on 5-6 hours plus by the time I went to bed and it was still charging. Once the battery is charged up, you are just going to put it into the bottom here, snap it in, and the device is going to power on. Next, we are going to download the app and start the setup process. Now the setup process is really easy. You're just gonna follow the on-screen instructions. Took me a few minutes here and I was connected and good to go. We are now going to remove the old doorbell and get this one installed. So first thing we did is I went outside and I turned off the breaker to the doorbell, pulled the doorbell out of the mount that I have for my setup. And for me, since the way my doorbell is positioned, I wanted to use one of the angle brackets. What I did is I set the level on top, I marked the holes that I needed, and then I took the drill bit and drilled this thing into place. Now, once the angle bracket was in place, I loosened the screws on the back of my doorbell, I connected the wires. One thing to note is that it does not matter which side you put the wires on. I tightened them down and then screwed the doorbell into the mount. Once the doorbell was securely in place, we put the cover on the front. I used the Torx bit to tighten it up and good to go. So one thing I wasn't sure about is I wasn't sure if my wiring would charge the battery or if my battery is something I'm gonna be needing to charge. I think it said every 4 to 6 months. If you go into the app, you can see here that it shows the battery indication. If you click on the battery, it will say hardwired if it is pulling power. If not, it'll show battery. Luckily for me, it was saying hardwired, so I didn't have to worry about the battery losing charge. Now, one thing I really like about the Video Doorbell 2 that I thought was pretty appealing is that It does have this built-in battery that you could remove when you need to charge it, but it allows you to put the doorbell essentially anywhere you want to. You don't have to put it where your doorbell is. If you want, you could screw this right to the middle of your door. One thing I noticed is that in a lot of the advertisements for the video doorbell, it shows that this is face level for everybody and it's got great lighting and a great picture. And I didn't find that to be the case where my doorbell was. It was low, it wasn't getting necessarily the best angles of people like it does in all the advertisements. But I guess you could just screw this to the middle of your door, put it right at face level and get the same results that they're getting from all the pictures that you guys are seeing online and in their commercials. Another idea for this is that if your front yard is gated off and you've got a gate up front and say don't want people to walk up to your front door, you can install one of these at the front gate. Because this doesn't require any hard wiring, it only requires a strong Wi-Fi signal. So essentially you can put this wherever you want. All right, now that this thing is installed, let's test it out. So diving into the app, one cool thing that I liked right out of the gate is that they have their own built-in community called Neighbors. It's a way for you to see the action that's happening around your neighborhood. If people are getting packages stolen or just seeing something weird going on, you could essentially share your footage in this community tab and show your neighbors what's going on. And in return, you can see what's going on in your neighborhood. So I thought that was a really cool feature to kind of bring the community of Ring users together. If we take a look, I'm gonna go ahead and click on the Ring doorbell here. So now that we're in the app, one thing you may wanna look into doing is setting up live view. This will allow you to access your camera anytime you want to. If you wanna see if there's any activity going on, you can just hit that and be able to see the live view. Now by default, that was turned off for me. So when I wanted to check live view, I wasn't able to do that. But one thing to keep in mind is if you want to turn live view on, if I enable it here, I get a pop-up that says, this won't take effect until the Ring doorbell detects motion and turns itself on. So when I was at work and I turned this feature on, it didn't actually take effect until I got home and walked in front of the camera to turn it on. So keep that in mind. The next thing in the step here is you're gonna want to set up your motion zone. So if we go into motion setting, click on motion zones, it's gonna ask us a couple different questions. Do I face a street? I'm gonna say no. And then it says adjust your motion depending on the slider. So I'm gonna slide it up and down here to see what I actually want to get in there. We want to say get this walkway, but nothing further. And then it's gonna ask which areas I want on and off. Okay, now that we've got the configuration done on the phone, let's talk about the experience of it. At first, I didn't like how often I was getting notified that people were coming to my door. I guess being at work all day, ignorance is bliss, and you think, nobody's at your front door. You're not home, nobody's at your door. But between salesmen coming to your door and solicitors dropping off little, you know, business cards and package deliveries, I don't know. It was kind of eye-opening to see how much activity is actually happening at my house when I'm not here. Once I got used to it though and passed it, I kind of liked knowing what was going on. I liked that I was constantly getting notified when something was happening at my door, and that I felt a little more secure that if somebody saw that I had the doorbell, if there was anything shady going on, they probably would have just turned and walked away. Now, I wanted to test the device out for myself to see what it was like as somebody at the front door and then also somebody in the house. So being somebody who's at the front door and pushing the button, because my doorbell is connected to the inside chime, when you push the button, not only does the inside chime ring, but it also rings at the door and there is a blue circle that starts spinning indicating that a connection is trying to be made. When I get the pop-up on my phone saying somebody is at the door and I answer it, the connection's pretty quick and smooth. I really enjoyed it. There didn't seem to be a whole lot of lag that I could tell, and I could hear the person on the other side fine. Now, being somebody who's outside the door and using the device itself, I thought the same thing. The audio sounded good. I was able to understand what the person who was on the phone talking to me standing at the door was saying. So I was very impressed with that. Now to go over some things that I didn't really like about the camera. I didn't think the picture quality was that great. I wasn't that impressed with it. Considering this device boasts to be a 1080p camera, it was all right. I mean, it was nothing amazing. I was kind of hoping that once I downloaded the video to my phone, that maybe the quality would be a little bit better and that maybe the the quality loss was just because I was over Wi-Fi. I didn't find that to be the case. When I downloaded it to my phone, it was the same quality as me watching it live. So I was kind of disappointed there. I guess my bar of 1080p is a little bit higher. I mean, thinking that my phone shoots 1080 video and comparing that to this, there's no comparison. Like, it's the camera on this is okay. I already mentioned that I didn't like for some of the settings, you either have to walk in front of the camera or push the button. I thought that was weird, and hopefully something that can be fixed in future software updates. And the last thing that I didn't really like with this camera, and maybe I'm just spoiled with the Arlo system that comes with 7 days of free cloud storage, is that this one doesn't come with any included cloud storage. So I think you get 30 days free of you being able to save clips and clips being recorded to the cloud so you can watch them on your phone. But after the 30 days, you have to get a subscription. Now, the subscription's not that much. I think the subscription is, I think it's like $3 a month, or you pay 30 bucks for the whole year. But essentially, you're gonna be paying that for the entire life of the device. You can run this without the subscription, but if you don't have the subscription, you only have the benefit of viewing live footage or taking a live call. You can't go back and watch anything recorded or download anything because nothing's being recorded. If I'm working or if I'm doing something or if I miss a call, I can't go back and look at that footage. If somebody shady comes up to my house, I can't go back and look at that footage. Or if I even answer the call and see that somebody shady is at the house, I don't have that footage. I don't like that. I wish that they would have included, even if it was just a day, give me a day, give me 2 days, that if something weird was going on and I checked that footage, that I could keep that footage. I could record it. I could save it and give it to the police if needed. I don't like that I have to have a continual subscription and now paying for this thing. But maybe I don't like that because I, for one, am spoiled with Arlo, and for two, I didn't realize it when I bought it that you essentially had to have a subscription. So knowing that going into the purchase probably wouldn't have been that bad. So anyway, guys, I think I covered most of the things for the Ring Video Doorbell 2. If you found this video helpful, give it a thumbs up. Let me know that you liked it. As always, don't forget to subscribe to the channel for more content like this, and I will see you guys in the next video.